Okay, so here we are back again, and like I promised, I've got a man who exhibited exceptional talent. As a matter of fact, he was so good at what he loved that he started playing public performances, or gigs, as they are called in the music industry, at the age of 12. Oh yes, at the age of 12, he was already good enough at what he did to go public with it. Of course, he went to school, he studied it, and he's already played with orchestras and even with superstars such as Craig David, Rihanna, and Kanan. A friend of mine told me that he's the best violinist I'll ever know, ever see. Well, Francis, good morning, welcome to Sunrise.
Good morning.
I have to tell you that my mother won a gold medal for playing the violin in Russia, and my grandfather on my mother's side was the first violin in the erstwhile Soviet Philharmonica, the national orchestra of the USSR at the time. So you're really gonna have to work hard to impress me.
Okay.
But I'm impressed already because I heard you play a little something. Can you do that again?
The same I did before.
Yeah.
It was like...
Hold on. That sounds like a sort of style that one would do, stuff that one would do with a guitar.
Yeah, it's true.
Not really a violin, because you've got your bow right there.
I've got my bow right here and I can use it, but...
You sure you went to a music school in München, Gladbach, to learn this? And
right.
You were taught by a guy called Joachim Reiser.
Yes.
His name rings a bell. He's kind of like a good teacher.
He's a very good teacher. Yeah.
A very good teacher. That's what he taught you.
No, not really. Since I was young, I was interested in listening to music and to just play without any sheet music, because when I was young, I was not good in reading sheet music. And so
That sounds like my grandfather. You know, he couldn't read music either.
Yeah, that's the way
But one day, the mother was putting the orchestra together, had him playing in a bar, in a cafe, and said, listen, who's playing that? I want him. And that was it. And he never learned how to read music anyway. He played everything, Tchaikovsky, Paganini, by ear.
Yeah, I do that as well. Of course, I learned to read sheet music later, and I studied music. I studied violin and piano in the Netherlands. But for me, I love to play music, and I'm often performing with DJs. They put up some music, and I play along with them, or I play with the bands. And my music style is like kind of reggae, hip-hop, jazz, R&B, different kinds, and not too much classical. I learned classical music my whole life, but I like to perform like music many people are going with me, and so
you're kind of like the 21st century Paganini, aren't you? You I bet you can play on just one string.
I can play on one string, of course. No problem.
Okay, play something for me with all the four strings and the bow.
With all the four strings and the bow.
And the bow, yeah. How's that?
But you see, this one is like that, so I can use like.
because I have to, you know, give a good explanation to my mother. You
okay.
Understand? She's like a classical musician.
Okay, then maybe I can do like.
Okay, I think it's my mother that's going to have to explain to me why she didn't teach me how to do that. How long did it take you to learn?
Oh, I started when I was 5, and I'm 24 now, so it's about 19 years.
A violin is a kind of an unusual instrument for a young person nowadays in 2012. It's more like the laptop for most musicians.
Oh, no, it's not that like that. For me, I started very young. We had neighbors, and they both played music. The man played violin, and his wife, she played flute. And my mother, when she went to work, they took care of me, and I have been there, and they teach me how to play flute and violin a little bit, and I become more interested in all the music stuff and went to concerts to listen to great musicians, and I developed myself with getting educated by teachers and to listen to music, and that's how it worked for me. And the computer in this time, I didn't have any laptop, so I think for you, I don't know how old you are, but I think when you were young, you didn't have a laptop, so.
No, I certainly didn't have a laptop.
Yeah.
I tried to make my own, though. It wasn't a laptop, it was just a cassette player.
Okay.
But coming back to your music, now you're fortunate enough to have two homes. Most people just have one home. You have a
it's
home
true.
In Germany, you have a home in Ghana.
Yes, right.
And I can see here that you've played lots of gigs in Germany. Are you here to play some gigs?
I also play, but not like big public gigs. I play, I'm here with the Medicine on the Move guys. They will come later.
And what's the connection between music and medicine, other than the fact that they both start with M?
There are many connections, because like medicine is something you need, music is something you need.
Medicine on the Move, so yeah. Do you play whilst they fly? Or
for example, I play when they are flying, but I also like, there are many people, like children, they take them and they help them, like with medicine, with all kind of diseases. And this people also, they appreciate music. So I'm there and I play for them. Even like last year when they worked on the fields, they had to build houses and stuff. And they were a little bit like, the sun was hot and it was hard work. And Jonathan just asked me, just maybe you can come and play some music for them. And I played and they loved it. It was really great.
Okay, now you've demonstrated that you play jazz, you play funk, you play classical music. What's your favorite?
My favorite? Oh, it's hard
genre.
To say.
Or a favorite piece, even narrowing it down more.
That is very hard to say.
Very hard
to
say.
Because I have many, many pieces I like. For me, I studied jazz music, and jazz music is the music I like very much, because like if you listen to hip-hop, if you listen to R&B or what else, there are some jazz influence inside. And that's what I like very much. And of course, if you go more back, like classical music is the stuff I started with. It's the music I like, and it's like jazz is developed from classical music. So of course, everything is connected. And also like gospel, I love gospel music very much and play it.
Well, it's Good Friday. Are you going to play us a gospel piece, maybe one of your own or one that you particularly like?
Of course, if you like some, no problem. I can do that.
I think my favorite gospel song is by Boney M, By the Rivers of Babylon.
Why not? You sing along with me, okay?
You see, the reason why I couldn't sing is my mouth was stuck like in that position.
But see, you
I've
know,
never heard anyone play the violin like that.
It's possible. It was like kind of Irish stuff inside. But you know, normally I play with a band, so normally I need like drums, I need bass and like guitar player. So I'm not like a solo player who plays like
bass and
yeah,
drums.
I mean, bass, drums, all the stuff which rocks. So
now that you're here, are you going to stay enough to do some research into traditional Ghanaian music, maybe teach some kids how to do what you do?
Definitely. I'm doing this. We on the airfield, I just gave some lessons. You will meet Patricia very soon, and maybe we can try later what she learned from me. It's quite good. And I, of course, I do it. My family here, I left violins for them to use, and it's really funny. So they like it, and they use it.
I tried to look you up online, and I'd like to share, you know, some links with viewers. Is there a URL that you can point us to where people can get a bit more of your experience, your playing?
Of course, yeah. You can just check my website as francisnorman.de.
Francisnorman.de, what? Spelled right. Together?
Hello. Yeah, Francis Norman, just together.
Yeah?
Yeah. .de. But I also can show it on a card like here.
You even have a card.
Yeah, of course.
Oh man, I don't have a card.
Like, you are sure?
Yeah, I'm sure I don't have a card.
Okay. Yeah. If you need some, I can organize some for you.
Yeah? Does your card play music?
If I rub it, would it
sound a little like you?
You can try it, but you have to listen very carefully.
It's a cool card. So do you make a good living as a violinist?
Yes, very good. I think I just wrote my bachelor thesis about like developing a musical career. And I also thought about like how it's possible to earn your money with music, because many people ask me how you can drive a car.
Yeah, how can you drive a car playing a violin? Who pays you?
Yeah, you see in Germany.
Well,
like,
I know Rihanna and Craig David must have paid you some money.
Of course, they did.
It did.
It's also some still on my bank account, so I'm not the man who spent all the money away for nothing. So it's. Yeah, but you know, I perform very much for big companies like Vodafone, like whatever, like international ones. Just 3 weeks ago, I have been to Dubai to play for SAP. It's a big software engineering company. And of course, this brings money. And if you are like able to like manage yourself and you take care about all those financial aspects, then you can get able to also like keep some money left and buy a car or whatever. And okay, I can say in Germany, it's more easy than in Ghana, but I know that if somebody has a passion for something, you will see it for the Medicine on the Move guys, because they started with nothing. And now it's an airfield, they're flying with planes, and I also fly a plane, I have a pilot license. So if you have a passion for something, and if you like, you love it and you want to do it, no, nothing can stop you.
Even nothing can stop you.
Anywhere in the world.
And you found your passion at the age of 5?
I don't think I found my passion. I loved it in this age, but I didn't thought about any like making money out of it. But
most 5 years think about football and bicycles and maybe some video games.
I also thought about that and I also used it. But for me, I like just I like to play. And sometimes my mom had to force me like to go and practice, and I did it. But finally, like when I came to an age about 15 or 14, I found out, okay, it's my thing and I want to do it. And in 2005, I had a very hard disease. Maybe you see all this stuff here. It was cancer. So I had like 1 year of chemotherapy and all this stuff. And this time really throws me out of my life and made my wish stronger to do music, especially if they start to cut something here. For violin players, really hard to have that. And after this time, like for 1 year from chemotherapy and all the radioactive stuff they used, the medicine, I was fine again, and it gave me more power to go.
So, and incredible also, story.
Yeah, thank you.
Are you working on an album?
I'm working on different albums. I also bring some, they are over there. I record, like, I'm not the artist, like a solo artist, so I have not my own album, but I recorded for different artists in Germany and in the US. I just recorded for Akura Naru, maybe you know her, she's from America, a very great female rap singer.
I'd like to hear you on your own album, maybe with some traditional percussion in the back.
Okay, it's very, too many people tell me that. Maybe I should pick it up and do it.
A xylophone, a traditional xylophone, a kora and a violin. I think it'll make an interesting combination.
It's true.
Francis, it's been amazingly inspiring meeting you and talking to you. Thank you very much for coming.
Thank
I look forward to meeting the rest of your friends. And like I said, this morning, it's a Good Friday edition of Sunrise. And I'm going to focus on good stuff, stuff that will inspire you, amaze you. If you think for a minute that the story of Francis Norman is something that is so, so, so beautiful, well, I've got three more, perhaps four, maybe five. So more good stuff to come. But Francis, before you go, just one more thing. Play something that you really love.
Oh, I really love. Okay, let's see, like.
Okay, one more time.
One more time. See you.
See you. See you right after this.
What starts right usually ends right. So start your day in high spirits every day with a delicious, creamy, filling mug of Nescafe breakfast. A delicious instant mix of coffee, sugar, and creamer. Nescafe breakfast. A great cup for a great day.
Hey, Charlie, the change you've been waiting for is here. Tigo has the lowest tariff in Ghana ever. Yes. Enjoy 3 Ghana pesos per minute to call all Tigo numbers. Yes, 3 Ghana pesos per minute. Wow. Just dial *555#. It's easy and it's free. It's simple. It's Tigo.
Tigo, express yourself.
Fashion is how we express our personalities. It's our way of saying, this is who I am. On this show, we explore the dress sense of Ghanaian celebrities. Who's wearing what? who's hot and who's not.
The beads around the neck don't work.
Makes her look kind of square.
بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم.